Now we have Hiro Nao, Mia Take. And please go ahead.
Yeah. So, right. So, today I'll let me talk about the cosmological constraints from the galaxy-galaxy lensing and clustering with IGC ER1 and BOSS data. So, this is the first application emulator-based Hello model to cosmology analysis, as Takahiro mentioned in his talk. So, I'm very excited to report this. Okay. So, yeah, why lensing and clustering? So matter correlation function is sensitive to cosmological parameters, but it's very difficult to measure because most of the matter in the universe is dark matter. On the other hand, galaxies are easier to observe, and we can compute the galaxy-galaxy clustering, but the galaxies are biased tracer of underlying matter distributions. And the amplitude of this quantity cannot be directly used to constrain cosmology. So this can be written like this. So delta G is a bias times the delta M. So this is approximation at the large scales. And then xi gg can be written as b squared times xi mn. So this bias parameter, this is what we have to know to get to constrain the cosmological parameters. So this bias parameter can be calculated by combining galaxy-galaxy lensing, because that gives a cross correlation between a galaxy and matter. And this becomes like B times xi mm. So using these two observables, we can calculate the bias and extract the cosmological information. This method is actually emerging as a standard method in recent 10 years. GIS and DES already got results out, and we are getting out our first results from HSC. And so this is a measurement we did. So we used the both spectroscopic galaxy sample as tracers. We divided that into three spins, and we applied conservative luminosity cuts to create a volume limit sample. So this clustering signal is measured from these both tracers. And then using these tracers as the foreground galaxies, and then using an HSC ER1 as source catalog as a background galaxies, we can measure galaxy-galaxy lensing. And we use ER1 data of HSC. So we have covered 140 square degrees, which is just 1/10 of the final survey. And we use our single resolution spin, like 1z = 1.34. And using these measurements, so far cosmology analysis often has been limited to large scales to avoid the theoretical systematics, such as the modeling a nonlinear regime and a galaxy halo connection. So normally, people use above 10 megaparsec or something. We want to push towards the small scales to exploit the data. And this is an emulator-based halo model. Which extensively uses a dark emulator introduced by Takahiro. And from cosmological parameters, so we can predict the halo-halo correlation and halo-mother correlation functions using a dark emulator with a few percent accuracy, even in a nonlinear regime. And then we analytically convolve the HOD to convert it to the galaxy-galaxy and galaxy-matter correlation functions. And then after 2D projections, we get these observables. So the point is that we combine the analytically HOD, and then we can marginalize the HOD parameters to obtain robust cosmological constraints. And the model details and extensive robustness tests can be found in this paper. And we are able to actually push down to the 2 megaparsec and the 3 megaparsec for lensing and clustering. And this model is publicly available in the dark emulator. So this is a big, big sneak peek. And this is the cosmological inference from that measurement. So we did lots of systematic tests. And then this is the result we got. So compared to the DES ER1 and the KIDS data, we got a comparable constraints even after a very conservative cut for the spectroscopic galaxies. So yeah, the paper will be out in a few weeks. So stay tuned. That's it.
Thank you very much.